Be a little different recording. I want to teach you folks how to create a Google spreadsheet and then graphs from there. So it's a little less edited, a little bit more lengthy, but I think it'll help those that have this need. So what I have up here is the home page for Google Drive. So I'm going to click Create Spreadsheet. And what comes up is a blank spreadsheet. So the first thing you may want to do is click on the untitled spreadsheet and give it a name. So I'm going to call this Google Tutorial on Making a Spreadsheet. Okay. And there the name pops up. Okay. And then the next thing you do is you enter data. So I have my data from the ticker tape lab. I'm just going to copy paste in because it's data that will help you guys. And I just want to copy the time and distance for the car A. And so I'm going to paste that in there. So just recognize it's always good to label. The first row is usually good to put a label. The next row is good to put that Y label, the dependent variable. And so I have my data now. The reason it's highlighted is right here. So if you click and hit shift, and select your range, right here in this box, you can do borders. So I can turn them off, or I can select them all. It's just more of a visual. And then to make a chart from this data, I can just highlight it. So again, select the range, and this icon right here, insert chart. And then more right here, you need to select more for the scattergram. 99% of the graphs we do in science are scatter plots. And there's that. And then it looks like I have some customized options. So I can give it a title. So this is, ticker tape lab, car A, distance versus time. Something like that. What was the other thing? Oh, I like to turn the legend off. Let me scroll down. Background, features, axis, horizontal, title, min, max. That might be in the start. Somewhere it is. I know I can get rid of it, but that's an idea of where it's at. And then you can move it around and resize it to where you want. I don't know why it's not. Let me grab it. There it is. So that's good data. It looks like a quadratic kind of graph, a curving graph. So there's that. But I'm going to get rid of this. Let's see if it lets me delete chart. So what I want to show you next is how I create equations based off the first data. So because we're going to make another graph, I'm going to just say equals this cell, the time cell. I'm just going to have it copy. So I hit the equal sign, click on the cell, click and drag it down. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I double click that cell, you can see it's a function equals A3, and it highlights it in green for us, and there'll be different colors depending on the function. Only this time, I want this column to be the change in distance compared to time, or in other words, velocity. Change in distance divided by t. In other words, slope. You guys know this function. It's y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So actually, I'm going to start with it. We can do that here. Okay, equals. Now you need to do parentheses for order of operation. Click on the cell Y2 minus Y1. And I had to put a space bar right there. In Excel, you don't have to do that, but I'm noticing you have to. Now that's not quite the full function I want. Divided by parentheses X2 minus X1. Close parentheses. That looks good. And now here's a cool feature. Once I've made this function, I highlight it and click on the little box, get the crosshairs, and I can drag it down. Okay, and so those, now if you notice, our function was based off of the second row minus the first row. I got to hit tab to clear, you know, to select a new box. If I double click this box, it's the same equation based off of the previous one. Now if you look, this one's not very valid because it's based off an empty cell. So I need to delete that. That one's not valid. And that's the tricky part about, it's one of the tricky parts about this exercise. So I don't want to go into the details of this, but just go with it. The velocities are good. These are your slopes, 0.5, 1.5, 2.5, 3.6. Those are good slopes. So we're going to do the same thing. I can make a graph off of this. But notice because I'm finding change of distances, I lose one data pair because it just ends up being an n minus one situation, just like we'll find out next. So I'm going to do it one more time. I'm going to create another column, time. Might as well just create the same thing, zero. I could type them in, one, two. I'm probably going to lose one more data pair set, so I'm going to not put the 3 in. And right here, I'm going to say y2 minus y1, only this time, actually, let me title this column. This is going to be acceleration or change of v versus t, or in other words, slope. So equals, I'm going to type in equals, this cell minus this cell. Need parentheses. Your formula is not correct. I know. I'm working on it. Divided by change in time. Ooh, that's not good. I didn't do it. I didn't click my cells right. Change in velocity. Divided by time. Again, order of operation. Better get my parentheses in there. Looks good. Hit enter, one. So I'm gonna pull this equation down. There. So I got my three accelerations. So for you calculus folks, yes, this is distance versus time. The first derivative is velocity. Second derivative is acceleration, or a slope versus slope of a slope. But don't worry about it. We're just trying to find the change of whatever it is, distance, velocity, or acceleration. So it looks like acceleration is pretty constant. 1.1 might have been a measurement error on my part as far as measuring the ticker tape lab. But it looks like the average is pretty close to 1. So that's it. That's a good view of how I created that spreadsheet earlier for you guys to help you with. Let me just show you one last thing, again, how to make a chart. And I'm going to make a chart here on purpose because this one will not look very good. And it's the limitations of Google spreadsheets, where something like Logger Pro or Excel, you have more options to change the axis. So if I click chart once again, remember you got to click more to get a scatter plot. There's a scatter plot. Clicking that. Let's go ahead and make a title. And this one's acceleration versus time, and that looks good. It showed up there. Notice, I'll go ahead and say insert. If you notice, it kind of defaulted the scale for me. Instead of the y-axis having a 0, 0 point, since the data is 1, 1, 1.1, that's what it made a graph of. And so that's not very useful. It makes it look like acceleration jumped up quite a bit here, and that's not the case at all. It's basically 1. So I haven't found a way to change that axis. Maybe Google will fix this in the future. But for sure with Excel or Logger Pro, you'll have more options to do that. And so let's say I want to take this to Excel. You can hit File, Make a Copy. No, I don't want to do that. I want to download as a Microsoft Excel document. So if I select this, then I can download it, bring it into Excel, and I'll have more chart options of scale and such. Logger Pro, again, is the best that I've found as far as flexibility with that to make a graph. And you guys can have a copy of that. Site license allows it, so make sure to follow up on that. Thanks for the ear. Hope this helped.